One more problem. So you remember there was a problem about a school for two villages. Now imagine we have four villages. A somewhere B, C and D somewhere. And they are not on one line. They are just somewhere. And we want to construct school. S for school. But now there is the same or just one student in each place. So we want to minimize all the distance for the A student, for B student, for C student, and for D student. We want to make this distance minimal. And the question is, where should we construct our school? So if you have some ideas, just write on your paper. And can you prove that this is optimal? I understand the answer, but why can you prove that it's an optimal? Пойти на одном количестве. В каждой школе, допустим, один человек просто. Right? Well, we just have some four points. And we need to find some fifth point S to make this minimum. So the total distance. There are each one student. M, Bob, D, and you want to find a four point which is the sum is minimum.
Некоторые из них стали лучше. К этому у нас надо быть. Нужно объяснить, что они суммы стали проигрывать в этой
пятимерке. Можете как-то написать доказательства или просто, что-нибудь такое написать на доске, чтобы было...
Когда вы видели, когда вы видели, поставили на этом риске.
Да. Okay, let me just say it for everybody. So there was an answer first. There are two parts of it. If we want to guess the answer and to give the proof. So the answer is we just construct, draw the diagram CB and AD and take the intersection point. Let's say S. Let's call it S, and this is called some other S prime. So what different people told me independently that this is the optimal point. So you need to explain why it's optimal. Why SA plus SB plus SC plus SD for green lines is better, or at least the same as S prime A plus S prime B plus S prime C plus S prime D. So you can explain it somehow. Okay, but maybe you can just write something. Not explaining, but just write something on the board so it will be clear for everyone. What should you write on the board? So S prime A, what the first one is?
S prime A plus S prime A.
So we look at this triangle.
Yes.
And triangle one. S prime A plus S prime D, yeah?
Is bigger than SS, say
S. That is bigger than the okay, but just let us first write that this is AAD.
AAD plus.
No, why plus? Just. Oh, it's bigger. Yeah, it's bigger. And A. AD is the same as AS. SA plus SD.
Yes.
So if we take S prime A plus S prime D, it's bigger than SA plus SD.
Yes.
Прозвучало здесь, что А, Б, С, Д – это не любой четырехугольник, а только выпуклый.
Yeah, there is a, no, there is another thing which we haven't discussed. So this is not for every position of A, B, C, D. If we have A, B, and C, D, then our trick doesn't work. We want to find something which is on A, B, to make this sum minimal, and also something on CD. And there is no common point. So this is not, our solution works only if there is an intersection for this. Even if we try different lines, we can group them differently. For example, AD and BC. Again, there is no intersection. So for these points, it doesn't work at all. And what do you think? Where should we put the school for such positions? If you are practical people and you have three villages here, where you will put it? No, not for three villages. We have still four villages, but they are like this. So our construction doesn't work. There is no intersection point. If we draw the line, they don't intersect. So what you will think? So where you will put it? But what is this? They can be difficult study for mission. It's not important where it is, but why? Why we can start something ignoring D? Почему вообще не обращаем внимания на D, а строим какие-то линии здесь?
А при чем здесь середина и перпендикуляр вообще?
Почему мы хотим построить ее, не обращая внимания на делки? Just imagine you are practical people. You don't know anything about geometry. You just have these four villages. Where we will play the school? Где вы будете строить школу, если вам... Yeah, the very logical thing is to construct it in if some C is inside the triangle AB, so it's, it doesn't make a quadrangle, but we get a triangle at some point inside. So the your recommendation is that construct in this. And but maybe you can prove why it's optimal. Почему вот это самое точка? Точка, которая внутри, может ли кто-нибудь объяснить, почему это будет оптимальный вариант?
Ну, а может, это не будет оптимальный вариант?
Может, не будет оптимальный вариант. Окей, it's even good that we have some problem that I cannot solve immediately. Just online. Is C always optimal? It's difficult to think just online. Imagine we have a triangle at the point inside and want to minimize the total distance. I think it's true, but so if it's in the C, then we have these three things. And if it's not in C, we have three other lines. And also we have this line. So we have some of these four lines. It should be bigger than the sum of these three lines. But the question is why, and I think it's true, but did you study some physics or not? Вы когда-нибудь физику учили?
Yes.
Okay, then I can explain. There is a general physical solution how to solve this problem using physics. And to solve this problem, not this problem, just find the minimum using physics. It's done like this. You need to make a model of your land.
Oh, I решил. И даже очень просто, да, так что они пока не поймут.
But okay. So what? How do we make a model? So imagine we have several points, A, B, C, D, or something like this, and we make a table, a horizontal table, and there are A, B, C, D signs. What we do, we make a hole in the table, we drill with this, make holes in the table, so there are four small holes. And then we do the following experiment. We take four heavy things of the same weight, груза, четыре гири, four weights of the same weight. And each of them has a line that goes from a small piece of rope. So it should be very smooth, so it goes through the hole without any friction. And so we make four pieces of this. And then, of course, they want to go down. So we need to keep them here. And what we do then? We just combine all of them to some point. So all the ropes go to the same. We make a knot here of all the ropes. So we have four ropes, and end points are combined into one place. And then we let them fall. So this. They go down and they form some this knot is on the table somewhere. So here is the knot somewhere. And it's connected to rope to the ropes go to the holes here. If I were better prepared, I can even bring such a thing for.
В одном из музеев науки местных такая штука, правда, есть.
Yeah, maybe.
По-настоящему сделанная.
So it's very easy to do. You can just, when your parents are not at home, You can make small hole in your nice table.
Нет, then... нет, там нельзя из веревок. У вас будет трение слишком большое. Там нужно втулки сделать. В точках А, Б, С там нужно поставить такие штучки, через которые перепрошены веревки.
Yeah, тогда не будет трения. Okay, if you can try to make less friction by making some rollers here, but it's more difficult. But actually, if you have some friction, it's not a problem. There is a way you can just make it like this, and then it will go. This friction will be not possible, not at all. And so the idea that all these things want to go down, and in physics there is something which is called my magical word energy or potential energy, and it's something which wants to be minimal. And so the and you can it depends on this sum as A plus S plus S. Так я скажу по-русски, значит, можно так, чтобы решить задачу на 4 перейти любого числа дырочек, можно сделать простую вещь. Можно просверлить в тех местах, где деревни, просверлить в стороне дырки. После чего поместить туда грузики на веревочку. Но веревочки должны быть очень гладкие, чтобы они там сразу не терлись. И потом все связать узлом и отпустить. Тогда этот узел натянется каким-то образом, и вот это будет самое лучшее положение. То есть вот, например, если у нас есть только две веревки, то что будет с узлом? Ясно, что он просто натянется по прямой от А до С. А в какой точке прямой? Все равно, потому что, ну, если это двигать, то это опускается, это поднимается, поэтому в целом никакого выигрыша и проигрыша нет. Это какое-то такое безразличное равновесие. Ну, а если вот будет 4 веревки, то тогда эта пара будет хотеть, чтобы он был на этом отрезке, а эта пара будет стремиться привести на этот отрезок. Но они попадут в точку пересечения. В точку пересечения. А вот, но в отличие от наших рассуждений, это годится с тремя веревками тоже. И, с тремя веревками, ну дальше можно сказать, что вот у нас это действует. На эту точку действует 3. So we have more or less this triangle like already we are done. There is a problem.
Давайте все решение, а? Пожалуйста, ну одно слово.
No. People should think, we should not. Do you know the solution? You know the solution or not? Вы знаете решение или нет?
Я знаю.
Okay, so if you can go and try to explain.
Мой по-русски.
Okay, try Russian. I will translate. So first of all, is it optimal or not?
Yes.
It is optimal.
Yes,
да. Утверждается, что это оптимально. Почему?
Да, если вот так.
Да.
Вот то грузик, ну, где-то тут стоит узел, грузик, который в синь, и себя тоже будет тянуть.
If this model is for weights, then this the four rows. And there is each of them pulls in some direction. So what? Будет узел в целую тянуть в четыре стороны. Above, below, the и чего?
Тогда?
И чего?
Это, ну, допустим, уже цель на себя тянул узел к себе. Когда на этот груз, ну, на эту дырку.
Нет, то вопрос в том, как раз перетянет ли оно его в цель или нет.
Проще говоря, ты не решил задачу. Используйте предыдущую, сегодня решенную задачу.